The New South Wales Liberals are bracing for a shock defeat to an independent following the by-election in Pittwater. With more than 60% of the vote counted, Jacqui Scruby is on track to become the first Teal MP in state parliament.
A by-election boogie, the dance of the Teals.
I did get sleep last night.
Independent Jacqui Scruby, poised to claim Pittwater.
An incredible swing towards community-backed independence.
The latest independent to invade Liberal heartland on Sydney's northern beaches. With over half the vote counted, the Teals are comfortably ahead of the Liberal Party. It suffered a 6% swing. High fives and tears from the Pittwater Liberal candidate, Georgia Ryburn, not conceding yet.
Path to victory, it's difficult.
A campaign that saw her directly targeted for living outside Pittwater.
While the Teal candidates like to push the narrative that they are the David and we are the Goliath, this isn't the case.
The by-election forced by the resignation of Liberal MP Rory Amon over child sex charges and coming after the Liberals bungled nominations for council elections.
In seats where we haven't had the sorts of challenges we've had in Pittwater, we've seen big swings to the Liberal Party.
In Epping, Liberal candidate Monica Tudorhope easily winning the seat vacated by former Premier Dominic Perrottet. Also straightforward, the Liberal win in Hornsby. And like here in Pittwater, by-elections without any Labor candidates in the field. The opposition leader says it's the government refusing to face the judgment of the voters. Electors have backed a candidate who had ambitions as a little girl.
People would say, what did she want to be? And she said she wanted to be the Prime Minister.
I think a career counsellor would tell me maybe I'm on the wrong path as an independent.
Chris Maher, 7 News.